Okay.
Hi, I'm Valerie, and I'm a pet care advisor. And today I'm here to show you how to measure your dog for a collar, and also to show you some different types of collars that are available. The first thing you want to do to measure your dog for a collar, oh, I have my friend Buddy here. I didn't introduce him, sorry. Buddy's here to help me, and we're going to measure him using a soft tape measure. If you don't have a soft tape measure like this, you can just use a piece of string, mark with your fingers where it fit on the dog's neck, and then measure that to a ruler. So we're going to get Buddy here, and we're going to take the tape measure around his neck, and it shows that he's about 18 inches. So we would want a collar that is at least 18 inches, if not bigger. And a typical type of collar is this quick release collar. These come in nylon and all kinds of colors. There's also buckle collars available. And the buckle collar is a little bit more limited because it just has the holes that are preset in it. These quick release collars open easily and they're almost always adjustable. This one's 15 to 25 inches and we have it pre-measured to fit Buddy. It just comes right around and clasps. And to properly fit, you want to be able to put two fingers between the collar and the dog's neck. Thanks, Buddy. Another type of collar that you can use is a limited slip or martingale collar. This one is made of all nylon. It has a nylon loop. This one has a chain loop. And the reason for the loop is if you have a dog that has a narrow skull that sometimes will back out of the collar, this will actually constrict on the dog's neck and prevent them from slipping out of the collar. There's also choke or slip collars. This is a choke chain collar. And the way that you would put a choke chain collar on is you run the chain right into the one ring on the end, and now you have a complete collar. Now this, because it's one piece, come here, buddy. Because it's one piece, it needs to slip over the dog's head. Buddy, come here. So when you order one, you want to actually, bud, come on. You want to measure the dog around the thickest part of his skull here, where he's broadest. And that's the measurement that you want. And then this would slip on over his head. And you can see he actually has one on now right here. You don't want to get a collar with a whole lot of excess chain. Now, there is a proper way to put these on. Most people walk their dog to the left. So if this is my dog and he's on the left, you want the collar to come across and then go through the ring so that when you pull up, it releases. If you have it on the other way and you pull up, it stays tight. If you have a dog with long hair, there's a special long chain called a fur saver choke. This prevents the coat from getting cut. Finally, we have a collar called a prong collar or a pinch collar, and this is used by trainers, and if you're going to use a collar like this, you probably want to be working with a trainer. These prongs don't stab the dog, they actually just pinch together and give a pinching sensation. These are best used on very powerful, strong dogs. Amazingly, when they are used properly, it takes a very small correction to stop a big dog from pulling. So that's all we have for today. Buddy's over here. Buddy, thank you very much for joining us, and we're going to talk about harnesses in our next video.